Disclaimer, this video contains copyrighted material, the use of which has not been specifically authorized by the copyright owner. We are making such material available for the purpose of criticism, comment, review, and news reporting which constitute fair use of any such copyrighted material as provided for in Section 107 of the U.S. Copyright Law, notwithstanding the provisions of Section 106 and 106A. The fair use of a copyrighted work for purposes such as criticism, comment, review, and news reporting is not an infringement of copyright. This video was created to abide by YouTube's terms of service. The purpose of this video is to discuss or critique greater issues. The creator harbors no malicious intent. This video may contain jokes, satire, and negative criticism of other individuals and their ideas, but is intended as a platform to discuss or critique greater issues, and does not constitute a personal attack or abuse of another individual. While this video may contain material that some may perceive as hurtful or negative, that is not the purpose of this video. This material is created for comedic or satirical purposes that are not intended to cause offense, humiliation, or engage in sexualization. Recordings in this video were made in accordance with the laws of the country in which the filming took place and were not created for malicious purposes. Viewers of this video are actively discouraged from engaging in harassment or abusive behavior toward other individuals. Links contained in the description are used to avoid plagiarism and misquotations by citing original sources.
What's going on, guys? Welcome to the Roast Games Cannibalism Cartoon Theory. The type of theory where I dig deep into every last cartoon series in the 1990s, from the early 90s to the late 90s. And for this very episode, we'll dig deep into
The Busy World of Richard Story,
which aired from March 9th, 1994 to 1997, with a total of 65 episodes in 5 seasons. The television series was based on the books drawn and written by Richard Scarry. Reruns of the show formerly aired in syndication as part of the Cookie Jar Kids network block. But the show now continues to air on the Cookie Jar and Toons block on this TV until October 26, 2013. Reruns of the show aired on Kubo from May 13, 2013 to September 25, 2016. However, it returned to Kubo on March 28, 2017, as part of the network's Night Owl block until May 26, 2018, and currently airs on Light TV. According to Vegan Australia, in an article discussing cognitive dissonance, it says, "How do people justify loving one but eating the other? In this special feature, we look at the psychological research into how individuals can hold two contradictory beliefs at the same time." And they used animals as an example, but when it comes to cannibalism, it's about loving the parent but eating the child. And that is terrifyingly true. According to Wikipedia, in A Theory of Cognitive Dissonance, originally published in 1957, Leon Festinger proposed that human beings strive for internal psychological consistency in order to mentally function in the real world. A person who experiences internal inconsistency tends to become psychologically uncomfortable, and so is motivated to reduce the cognitive dissonance by making changes to justify the stressful behavior, either by adding new parts to the cognition causing the psychological dissonance, or by actively avoiding social situations and contradictory information likely to increase the magnitude of the cognitive dissonance. It started at the end of season 4, then it happened again at the end of season 5. Not just because of the Christmas-themed episodes, but it was getting closer to the end of the 90s, and it was at the end of these two seasons, specifically episodes 49, 64, and 65. The show stopped making new episodes in 1997. Just over a year later, families started slaughtering and eating their own children as their Christmas roast, after they refused to believe in Christmas. The show title seems ironic. The Busy World of Richard Scarry. How come people pronounce it Scarry instead of Scarry like it is? Well, I guess I have proven my point here. Also, let's look at the definition of the word Scarry. According to Merriam-Webster, the definition of Scarry is bearing marks of wounds or scarred. But people pronounce it Scarry. Well, I guess they did not want their childhood to be ruined. It's not necessarily a pun, it's a fact. Now that's the Busy World of Richard Scarry. I'm Brian Mullins the Fox, signing out.